There was this time just over 5 years ago where I went from getting about 6 hours of sleep a night to 8 or 9 hours. And day after day with these extra hours of sleep under my belt, I felt so tired. I couldn't focus, I was forgetful and really moody. So I became slightly obsessed with sleep research in a quest to figure out what I was doing wrong. So here's the BrainCraft guide to better sleep. Whether you're struggling to fall asleep, stay asleep, or you just want to improve the quality of sleep that you are getting, here are 5 ways to sleep smarter, backed by science. So keeping a regular sleep routine is really important. This includes setting time to wind down before bed and then going to bed and getting up at the same time every single day. This is because your body's internal clock plays a key role in regulating your sleep-wake cycle. So it tells your body when you should start feeling sleepy at night and then when you should wake up in the morning. And if you're going to bed and getting up at a different time every single day, you kind of mess that up and it's more likely you're going to be feeling drowsy and sluggish. And you may experience what's called social jet lag, the tiredness you feel when you get up at a different time on your days off work or school. What happened to me 5 years ago is that I quit my job in science to be a full-time YouTuber. So I stopped setting an alarm, I stopped commuting, and I started working from home. So I didn't have a routine. I was going to bed and getting up at a different time every single day, and my body clock was messed up. That is why I felt so tired. Too much light in the evening can also disrupt our internal clock and make it difficult to fall asleep. So you have this brain structure called the SCN, which regulates your levels of the sleep hormone melatonin. So during the day when it's light outside, melatonin is suppressed and you feel awake. And then in the evening, as the lights dim, it starts to rise and that contributes to you feeling sleepy. Because this process is tied to light, when you use devices in the evening or you're exposed to bright light, it can interfere with your melatonin levels. Once you have fallen asleep, light can disrupt you and cause you to wake up during the night. So controlling the light in your bedroom is really important as well. Street lights or early sunrises can disrupt us, so blackout blinds or a sleeping mask, a face mask, can help. Our brain is hardwired to respond to our environment, so if you hear noises while you are sleeping, you will probably wake up. This can disrupt your sleep and also stop you from transitioning into deeper sleep stages, which are more restful and restorative for your body. Noise can come from lots of places, whether it's outside your window or your partner snoring. So it's a good idea to drown out everything by using something like a white noise machine. I use a fan, which acts pretty similarly, or you could go with good old-fashioned earplugs. It's important to be comfortable while you're sleeping, obviously, and research suggests the ideal temperature for you to sleep in is 15 to 19 degrees Celsius, which I think is 60 to 67 degrees Fahrenheit, which I will check and put here on the screen for you. But an ideal sleeping temperature does vary between people, so the most important thing is making sure that you're comfortable and not waking up overnight. Just being comfortable might seem intuitive, but there is more to temperature because your body temperature does rise and fall over the evening. And a trick to help you fall asleep is having a hot shower or a bath before you go to bed. This will cause your body temperature to rise, and then the quick cool down that you experience after makes you feel sleepy. And finally, separate your spaces because your bed should only be for sleep. Get computers, TVs, and work stuff out of your bedroom so you can help strengthen your mental association between bed and good sleep. Having workspace in your bedroom or working in bed can encourage you to work too close to bedtime, which can lead to increased stress hormone production and alertness, which you don't want. This has been the hardest thing for me because I love working in bed and watching YouTube videos in bed late at night, and it's taken years for me to finally set up some other workspaces and comfy spots around my apartment. You might be thinking that a lot of these tips seem like common sense. They seem easy, but it's hard to take all of them into consideration and to take them seriously. And sometimes we need a reminder. I still have a lot of trouble using my devices too close to bed, working too close to bed, working in bed, watching TV from bed, and all of these things that I've been trying for years to break the habit. It can also be overwhelming to try to overhaul your sleep all at once. So pick one area, focus on one thing, and when you have that sorted, come back, look to another area, and you can keep going. Most importantly, remember that sleep is a natural process. You have been doing it your whole life. Often we do get more sleep than we realize, and sometimes it only takes a few behavioral tweaks or tweaks to your environment to make a good night's sleep great. As always, thank you to my patrons for supporting BrainCraft and allowing me to make these videos. I am very passionate about sleep, and there is a lot coming up on sleep on BrainCraft. So keep an eye out for that.